King of Denmark has died mysteriously. His brother, Claudius, has seized the throne from Hamlet, the rightful heir, and married the widowed queen, Gertrude.
Yet of Hamlet, our dear brother's death, the memory be green. Yet so far hath discretion fought with nature that we with wisest sorrow think on him, together with remembrance of ourselves. Therefore, our sometime sister, now our queen, have we as 'twere with a defeated joy taken to wife. Nor have we here in Bard your better wisdoms, which have freely gone with this affair along. For all, our thanks. But now, my cousin Hamlet, and my son.
A little more than kin, and less than kind.
How is it that the clouds still hang on you?
Not so, my lord. I am too much of the sun.
Good Hamlet, cast thy nighted color off, and let thine eye look like a friend on Denmark. Do not forever with thy veiled lids seek for thy noble father in the dust. Thou know'st 'tis common all that lives must die, passing through nature to eternity.
Aye, madam, it is common.
If it be, why seems it so particular with thee?
Seems? Madam, nay, tis. I know not seems. Tis not alone my inky cloak, good mother, nor customary suits of solemn black, together with all forms, moods, shapes of grief that can denote me truly. These indeed seem. For they are actions that a man might play. But I have that within which passeth show. These but the trappings and the suits of woe.
'Tis sweet and commendable in your nature, Hamlet, to give these mourning duties to your father. But to persever in obstinate condolement is a course of impious stubbornness. 'Tis unmanly grief. We pray you throw to earth this unprevailing woe and think of us as of a father. Let the world take note, you are the most immediate to our throne, and with no less nobility of love than that which dearest father bears his son, do I impart toward you. For your intent in going back to school in Wittenberg, it is most retrograde to our desire, and we beseech you, bend you to remain here in the cheer and comfort of our eye, our chiefest courtier, cousin, and our son.
Let not thy mother lose her prayers, Hamlet, I pray thee, stay with. Go not to Wittenberg.
I shall in all my best obey you, madam.
Why, it is a loving and a fair reply. Be as ourself in Denmark. Madam, come.
Oh, that this too sullied flesh would melt, thaw, and resolve itself into a dew. Or that the everlasting had not fixed his cannon against self-slaughter. Oh, God! God! How weary, stale, flat, and unprofitable seem to me all the uses of this world. Fie on it, huh? Fie. 'Tis an unweeded garden that grows to seed. Things rank and gross in nature possess it merely. That it should come to this. But 2 months dead. Nay, not so much, not two. So excellent a king that was, to this, Hyperion to a satyr. So loving to my mother that he might not beteem the winds of heaven visit her face too roughly. Heaven and earth, must I remember? Frailty. Thy name is woman. A little month, or ere those shoes were old with which she followed my poor father's body, like Niobe, all tears. Why, she, even she, oh, God, a beast that wants discourse of reason would have mourned longer, married with my uncle, my father's brother, but no more like my father than...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.